Hey guys, welcome to more Total Warhammer 2 online action. Today we are doing the video in English since I had a Polish opponent in this battle and we had a good chat in the lobby and he wanted to have a look at the battle on YouTube after it was over, so today we're doing this in English once again and we're going to war with the Imperium versus the foul beastmen, stinky stinky beasts. And in this battle I wanted to play a more range heavy build with the Imperium, since that so we have the Hellblaster Volley Gun as well as three units of Empire Crossbowmen. It's always pretty risky to bring so much range versus the Beastmen, since they are so fast and they can easily circumvent your defenses and get onto your vulnerable crossbowmen and artillery pieces, etc. So we have some defenses. We have one unit of Royal Altdorf Griffites, which should be able to deal with pretty much any threat the Beastmen can bring against us, even the Minotaurs with great weapons. We also have one unit of Reichsguard, one of the more cost-effective cavalry units in the game. Also one unit of Spearmen defending our Hellblaster Volley Gun over here. One unit of Flagellants behind our range dudes here, so they can defend potential flanking attacks and hold up the enemy while the crossbowmen are shooting. Yeah, like units like the Centigors or something, which are trying to get to them to pieces. The front line consists out of four units of spearmen with shields. They are there to absorb the damage of the shock damage and hold up the enemy infantry. Also, for this purpose, we have two units of these captains of the Imperium with us, with the ability Hold the Line, which gives your spearmen charge defense against all. I think if I understand the tooltip correctly, then maybe I think that should be the right interpretation of this text there. Also two units of Flagellants, so you see the infantry corps only is there to hold up the enemy. They are not there to kill the enemy, but only to give our range units enough time to kill them with the range fire. Also Balthasar Geld with the final transmutation and his two items. So we have these Empire captains of the Empire here amongst the crossbowmen. That's something I did by mistake. Actually, they should be over here amongst the spearmen so that they can get the buff from the captains. So they hold the line buff. Since the infantry of the Beastmen have a very, very, very high charge bonus, so that's pretty important to give these spearmen the capability to hold up as long as possible. And our opponent, he has also a pretty interesting and strong well-rounded Beastmen build with two Centigors with great weapons hidden in the woods. Also, he has a frontline consisting of Goreherd with shield, Bestigors in the center, and more Goreherds with shields. These guys are actually a pretty good pick versus the Empire, and I also like to bring them when I play this matchup, because they have shields. They can trade pretty cost effectively with most Imperial infantry, and up fast they can circumvent the flanks, etc., etc. He also has two units of Angor Raiders, one unit of Angor Spearmen protecting these two range units, one Saigor, not the summoned one but the real one, and a Deathcaster with Fate of Buna and Spirit Leech. Also the what's the name in English? Yeah, his item which buffs his magic, and Morgo the Shadow gave. So pretty well-rounded build from my enemy here. And I tell you in advance, this battle is so damn close. It's really unbelievable. One of the closer battles I've had in a really long while. So strap yourselves in and get ready. So we advance with Balthasar. He's able to dodge most range attacks with his pretty insane speed and try to get some final transmutations in. But my opponent starts screening me out with his Centigors, but these throwing axes have a pretty hard time in my experience to hit flying targets if the flyer makes a good job dodging their attacks. So we are casting one final transmutation on the Deathcaster, since I know that he's one of the bigger dangers for Balthasar. In the meantime, the Hellblaster Volley Gun starts ripping apart these Centigors with throwing axes. These guys are already at pretty much half their HP. So the Hellblaster Volley Gun does a really good job defending these guys. But on the other hand, the Saigor has in the meantime pretty much devastated one of the Crossbowman units here. With his range attacks, he's so damn accurate, and he will show later in the battle that he's pretty much like he's equipped with a sniper rifle with his one eye. Actually, he shouldn't be able to see in three dimensions if he only has one eye, but okay, that's okay. So here at this point I realize at the last moment that I have to bring my captains here to the front line. And I managed to get into the fight with them just in time. Actually, not quite in time, because only two of my four units of spearmen have got the charge defense against all. So, actually, if we are here right now, we can examine the effectiveness of this ability. And it's not that easy, because only the units which are fighting the Bestigors have got the Hold the Line ability. The ones who are fighting the Goreherds over here, they didn't get this ability. So it's not a good test, but you can see they take a lot of damage from the charge from these Bestigors and are already at half HP, and the morale is at 23, so that's pretty devastating for my spearmen. But we have the secondary line of Flagellants who can jump in and help out these spear guys. At least when they start fleeing, they can jump in. Actually, over here, my opponent tries to flank around with one unit of Goreherds. We can use these Flagellants to catch them. On the other side, he managed to get one unit of Hounds around the flank. But they get devastated by the Reichsguard and by the Flagellants, which are sandwiching them. The Crossbowmen are just in front of these guys. So they evaded their fate really by only a hair. But Morgu starts summoning his spawns over here, and that this buckles the spearmen immediately. They are pretty much out of the picture right now, but it's okay, since my opponent didn't have enough resources to get to the Hellblaster Volley Gun, which right now has this super annoying line of sight bug, which causes it to march right towards the enemy right now, which is a pretty annoying thing at the moment with all Black Powder units. The Royal Alt of Griffa fights chased off one unit of Hounds over here, which are routed off now, and I will bring them back to the battlefield in no time. So the Bestigors are now pretty much at the secondary defense line of my army here. They have cut through the first line of spearmen and are now entangled with these secondary spearmen and Flagellants over here. At this point, my opponent manages to get one unit of Gores into the Hellblaster volley gun, which is a pretty big problem for me. Also, on the left flank, his Centigors are coming back out from the woods and are starting to pepper my Reichsguard with the axes. The Reichsguard actually have shields, which helps them defend these against these axes, but they nevertheless take a lot of damage because of their armor piercing. Balthasar Geld gets one really nice final transmutation over here into a big blob of Beastmen containing Morgul the Shadow Gave, which is a pretty big boon for me because final transmutation is, as you know, a spell versus single entity units. But it also does damage against normal units like infantry units and such. So this is a pretty big loss for my opponent here. And Morgul starts to waver, especially since he gets damage from these two Empire's captains here. Now he starts to rout. We are getting in there with Balthasar, which was a pretty big mistake since I didn't see that these Chaos Spawns were here, and they are capable to keep Balthasar from getting off again with a big mass. But we get lucky, and Balthasar gets back off in the air. So we start chasing Morgul. But we have to retreat since these two Angor Raiders are here, and they could have peppered Balthasar with the arrows while chasing Morgul, which would have killed Balthasar in no time since he has a pretty weak armor, only 50. The arrows could pretty much devastate him. We try to get one charge in there, but then we have to retreat. The Reichsguard is cycle charging these flanking Gauss, which is not very healthy for the Gauss since they have a pretty weak melee. They have such a low armor and pretty average melee defense. But the real battle deciding fight is taking place over here, where Morgur gets beaten down by these Royal Altdorf Griffites, which have come back from over there, from the Shadow Realm, and are taking care of Morgul and his remaining Centigors with throwing axes over here. Actually, I should have had them there a long time ago, but better now than never. And Morgul is getting pretty much pounded here. The Saigor still keeps throwing rocks into my army, and there goes down. There Morgul goes down. It's a pretty big boon for me right now, since the Beastman morale starts to get pretty low at this moment, and we have a mass rout right now. The only thing which keeps my opponent's army from routing in its entirety is this Saigo here throwing his rocks against these Griffites, and also and pretty much doing really good damage against this unit of actually low model unit of Griffites, which should be not the primal purpose of this Saigo, but nevertheless they are really healthy at this moment and can take some damage for me. Balthasar is alive, but only with 470 HP, which is really only a threat. His life is on one threat, and you can see now that's what I was talking about earlier when I was talking about the sniping Saigo. The Saigo targets Balthasar and hits him again and again, and with this rock, which didn't really hit Balthasar, but these rocks also have a small explosion radius, and this radius got Balthasar and took 300 HP off of him, which was pretty bad because now he's wavering and fleeing the battlefield. I hope that he comes back, but this happened pretty close to the edge of the map, and since Baltasar is so fast, he can also flee really fast, and now he goes over the ridge of the map. So the only thing we have left is this pretty healthy captain, who is only 260 HP strong. He was also fleeing right now, and now I get too close to my enemy's range units, which allows him to take off pretty substantial part of my captain's HP over here, which sends him routing. So this was pretty bad for me, because I didn't have these two guys were my last few officers I had in the game, and if they would have died, my army would have suffered morale penalties for having no leader left on the field. So it was really nice that the captain got his nerves together and started to come back to the fight, but right now he is nowhere to be found, and is over here in the back line, hiding from the enemy, this coward. The only thing I have left are these Griffites, which are taking care of these Centigors right now. But my opponent reacts pretty quickly and gets his Bestigors and the Saigo in. So I have to flee with my Griffites, since the Bestigors would rip them apart in the prolonged melee combat, since they have such high weapon damage and also pretty good melee attack, which can get through pretty easily against these Griffites. So the biggest danger right now for my Griffites are this unit of pretty healthy Bestigors. The only hope I have against these guys is cycle charging them, which I do right now with this pretty beat up unit of Bestigors. So these guys should have no problem sending them off the battlefield. You can see they are starting to rout, and we can send them off by chasing them. Over here, one unit of crossbowmen and the captain have routed, and this means that I do have the range advantage right now, since the Saigo has no ammunition left. But this is actually a pretty balanced fight, balanced unit composition, like the Bestigors and the Saigo and these Bestigors against these Griffites and the crossbowmen with the captain. Since these guys should have no problem taking out this Saigo, but the hard counter for the Griffites are these Bestigors right now, and this means that I have to find some way to get rid of the Saigo whilst keeping these Bestigors at bay, because if my opponent puts his Saigo in between these Bestigors, we have no possible way to get to him and kill him without taking a lot of damage from these Bestigors. So right now we are chatting, my opponent and me, and I'm apologizing for drawing out this game, but I have to use every advantage I can get to win this, and so I use up my ammunition from these crossbowmen to kill the Saigo, or at least take off some HP, since the Saigo also is a pretty good target for these crossbows, since he has a big hitbox as the monster that he is, and he has pretty low armor, 50. So it's the only reasonable thing to do, to shoot at him, and my opponent knows that he can't catch me, and he should have gone after these crossbowmen in this situation, but he didn't do it. He was resting his troops to prepare them for the inevitable fight against these remaining Empire troops, and you can see the balance of power is still pretty much dead even. So now we have no other choice but to attack my enemy. I send in the... I prepare my little contingent here, the crossbowmen, together with the captain of the Imperium, and set up these Griffites here for a side charge. But my opponent starts going after these Griffites, so I have to retreat them a little bit. But now I decide to have a small little charge in there, since the Bestigors were moving. I was figuring that I could have... that I should get some damage in, since they, as long as they're not raised. But we lose one Saigor with the attack of the one Griffite with one attack of the Saigor. And now this is the final epic showdown between the Beastmen and the Empire. The problem in this situation is that only the Griffites are immune to the terror of the Saigor, since the Saigor is a big scary monster. He induces terror into my troops, so they are fleeing right away after taking a few auto attacks from the Saigor. But the Griffites are immune, since they cause terror themselves, and they can stay in the fight a little longer. And you can see they have no problem taking out the Saigor with the dedicated anti-large capability. But the Bestigors are getting back, and this is a big problem, because if they get there, I'm pretty much screwed.